while walking the edge between serious journalism and serious filmmaking. That's what award-winning documentary filmmaker Michael Kirk says was the initial intent for the PBS program Frontline, born back in 1983. During a recent visit to WXXI, he said it's a mission that continues to be fulfilled to this day as the investigative documentary series covers the depths of the human experience around the globe.
Back at the very beginning of Frontline, the three networks had their own broadcast, but they were sort of thoughtful, white paper, kind of old school television. Our effort was to take a hard look at America and deliver with a kind of sensibility that was a public television sensibility to a public television audience the difficult and complicated issues of the day that faced the nation and also the world. Walk that edge between serious journalism and serious filmmaking.
Boko Haram attacks like this one are an almost daily occurrence.
The bottom line on any front line that we make is, will it help citizens who see the film go into a ballot box or make an important decision about who to vote for or what to vote for?
We're killed instantly.
Explaining things that others don't take the time, don't have the resources, and don't have the inclination to do, which is go deeply in depth into a very important topic that we decide the American people need to know and understand. It's so easy in the journalism business, and almost an unwritten rule, that when something happens, you have to be there, and you have to be there first. And increasingly, with the technology and the existence of live satellites, you can be there. And there may be value to witnessing what happens immediately. But the effort to be right and thoughtful and pull that all together is missing from that part of the equation. The front lines, and my personal journalistic goal, is to wait until the circus has left the town, is to say, now's a chance to step back. Enough time has passed to carefully consider what actually happened here, why it happened, to find the characters that were involved, to pull together the pieces you may think you know about an important subject. And at the end of the process, have you say, I thought I knew all of that, but you know what? I didn't know that. I didn't know that's why it happened. We're exploring lots of different ways to reach the younger generation, while at the same time keeping faith with our original idea and our deep and profound belief in long-form journalism as the most important thing we do. We have created an extremely robust website with daily journalism components, with pieces that come out of our films that work well on the web. We're heavily into social media to not only spread the word, but to show pieces from our film that we hope will appeal to a younger audience and entice them to sample and experience what true long-form journalism really is all about. This is not a quick hit. This is not a food fight. This is not journalistic gotcha. This is laying it out fairly, intelligently, with, I hope, a level of sophistication and understanding that comes from the time on the air, the time to think about it, the time to research it, the time to shoot it, the time to consider the various dimensions. That's the beauty of it. And almost nobody in journalism, certainly virtually nobody in broadcast journalism, does what we do. I think they wish they could. We're very fortunate to have a home in public television where we can. And stations like the Rochester station, WXXI, that encourages it and supports it. It's a rare thing that started more than 30 years ago and continues to flourish.
Be sure to tune into Frontline on Tuesday nights at 9 o'clock right here on WXXI TV.